Oh, I'd like to spend just a few moments talking about standard styles and implementation and drawing setup of Civil 3D. Most of you realize or have started using Civil 3D or read the blogs or read or seen the demos, you'll realize that everything is set up in the drawing template. And it's very important to set the drawing template up to be successful with the program. That's just a part of it. I want to kind of talk about a little bit of everything from a 30,000 foot view today, and just spend a few moments going through everything that needs to be set up. And you can really see once it's set up, you can be productive and create these sheets. So if you've seen some of our other videos, other V-books, you'll see that we're using sheet sets, we're using drawing templates. You can really be productive in creating this set of plans if everything is properly set up. And it goes way beyond just the drawing template. There's a lot more that needs to be involved. You may have heard of country kits or state kits. Those are something Autodesk produces. Take the version of what we call a state kit or what they call a state kit. And it's really just a set of standards that are implemented within your company's, in your firm, company, agency, whatever. But they're all the same. It's basically your standards when you boil it down. So let's look at just a couple items that may need to be set up when you're talking about standards. I have this Civil 3D 2010 standards here, you see. And in this drawing, in this directory, I've got DSTs, which are drawing sheet sets. So if you look at the drawing sheet set basically is how to create, you can create as many of these as you want, but that drawing sheet set comes back over here that shows you with all these subsets what plans need to be created for that particular project. So you may have a subdivision project that requires certain plan sets. You may have a site project that requires a different set. You may be working on just an exhibit or a due diligence report. You could create a sheet set for that as well. Survey projects, ALTAs, boundaries, topos, each one of those could be a different sheet set. And what that does is sets the user up to say, okay, we need a cover sheet, we need our site plan, we need our soil samples, we need a runway, our plan and profiles, and our cross sections, so they know what sheets need to be created. So that's one piece. The other piece, obviously, is of course the drawing templates. So, what drawing templates are going to be used, not only the drawing template for the design, but also your borders. All right, so the borders are important because you got your standard cover sheet. You may have metric versus imperial. You're going to have maybe plan and profile sheets that could be a different cover. So those are important to set up. And it's very important that you make sure that their proper styles are in not only the design drawing template, but also in the your borders as well. I have something I hear I call a library, and the library is where I put in my symbology. I create these drawings for my standard details, organize them into this library folder, and in that library folder is actually path to tool palettes. So I also have a bunch of tool palettes that are set up that we can use and make not only the process of creating drawings easier, but also finding information such as north arrows, title blocks, standard details, and I'll show you an example of that here in a second. Pay item data, this is new to 2010, so you're going to want to create this if you want to take advantage of the quantity takeoff feature of 2010. This PDWTs, those are project templates. So this is my directory structure. So inside the directory structure, I've got drainage, utilities, bridges, roadways. This could be all the files that you're going to need set up for a project. If we went out and we actually looked at a project, here's one where I have a different directory structure. And this directory structure has GIS data, imagery, reference drawings, production drawings. I don't want to have to create these folders every time I start a new project. That's what this PDWTs does for me. It sets up all those files and folders. File management is very important. A pipes catalog, if you're going to customize your structures, you have different size catch basins, manholes, pipes, you want to set up and customize the pipe catalog. Publish settings, this is your CTB files, your STB files, whatever you're going to use. I also put those in a standards folder. Road design, this is just, this is my assemblies, my cross-section assemblies that are also part of my palette. And then under survey, I have all my survey information, my description key file, my figure prefix file, my line code file, my survey database settings file. Put all that information under the survey folder. So again, that's kind of the main thing, is that outlining that directory structure for your standards. This standard folder will then go on a network somewhere, and then everybody in Civil 3D is going to be pathed to that particular network. So again, that's kind of all the components that really need to be set up. And once you have that, then you can really start working with Civil 3D, and you don't have to, you know, spend a lot of time changing labels, changing styles, and doing all the cleanup. You can concentrate on the design. But again, it's important that you have all those set up. So it's not just a drawing template. The drawing template, yes, is key. And in the drawing template is obviously where you're going to set up all your settings, your point styles, your label styles, your command settings. All that's very important in the DWT, but it also goes beyond the DWT into all the other files. And if everything is properly set up, it, again, it'll make life a whole lot easier. I do want to show you the palettes real quick. Most of you are probably familiar with these standard palettes that ship with the program. And you've got this, you know, these palettes here. And one of the things that I've done is I've created custom palettes, where those custom palettes have a bunch of additional features. So this is also important and key to set up and make life easier. So you can see I've got, move this over a little bit so it's out of the way, is I've got symbology features. So I don't have to go find that block, but what I've done here is I've also created some standard line tools. So when I do a building outline, I don't have to set the layer. All I have to do is go to my tool palette, pick on that command, and it will automatically set the layer and start drawing the line the way I want. So I've set it up. Basically, we've got north arrows, scale bars, erosion control information. You know, all this stuff is pre-set up on these palettes. It makes it very easy for me to go grab the block or the tool and start working with it. The next step, after you've established all this, it's very important to document it. Now, you can spend hours and months documenting stuff traditionally in a Word document, PDF file. What we've done is, just like I'm talking to you here, is the ability to create a VBook that documents all these standards. So this is my VBook library that not only has all my Civil 3D training information, but also has a my standards VBook. So in my standards VBook, I've documented all this information. Now, it's very hard and difficult to sometimes describe what you want the user to do, but it's very easy for you to explain it to them in a fashion like this. So one of the things that we can do, as you'll see here, is I have this VBook, it's broken out. I can look at, you know, talking about setting up the content. So if I've got a user who's working on a laptop and they need to set some stuff up, how do they do it? Well, here I am, just like I'm talking to you, explaining to them how they need to go about setting it up. If I look at the, I can also go to download data. So I can deliver the styles and standards to them in this VBook as well. The other thing I can do is do a styles demonstration. So instead of just saying that this particular surface style should be applied to the surface, I can explain it in less time than it takes me to write it. So again, documenting all this stuff in a VBook is a lot more efficient than just doing it in a paper document. Plus, it's there with all their other learning material in one location, one simple login. So again, just want to spend a few moments, just because of my limited time with this particular clip, and talk to you about that and just give you an idea of what's really required doing a Civil 3D implementation, standard setup. This is all the things that we look at when we're asked to do this particular a project such as this, is to do an implementation. We look at all of these features as a whole and then try to conform it to the way you work within your jurisdiction, county, city, state, what have you. Thank you.